What's up guys, Sal here. So when foldable smartphones were finally made official in 2019, there were two types of approach to this new form factor. Either inward fold with the screen closing in on the user, or the outward fold with the display side bending backward away from the user. Samsung chose an inward folding design for the original Galaxy Fold, while companies like Huawei took the outward fold approach for their first two foldable phones, the Mate X and Mate XS. As is the case, whenever two philosophy emerges, each side had its supporters and detractors. In the tech media, a lot of us here preferred Samsung's inward fold approach because the flexible screen is protected when folded. But there are quite a lot of people, including some big YouTubers, who preferred the outward fold style because it looked good from a visual point of view, but mainly because they didn't like the inward fold style required a second smaller screen on the outside. Huawei's consumer boss Richard Yu had even criticized the inward folding approach of Samsung during the Mobile World Congress 2019, saying that it's a bad design as it needs a second screen. But last month, with the Mate X, Huawei has conceded that the inward fold style is the superior way to fold, as the Mate X is a total ripoff of the Galaxy Z Fold 2 with a bigger screen inside and a second screen outside that folds inwards. And today, Xiaomi has also unveiled their first ever foldable phone, the Mi Mix Fold, with an inward folding design as well, just proving that Samsung had the right folding idea all along. Xiaomi's cutting-edge Mi Mix series is back, but this time in the form of foldable. Although the Mi Mix Fold looks like a total rip-off of the original Galaxy Fold, except for a bigger screen outside, but it is packed with some innovative features. So much so that the folding display may not even be the most interesting component on the phone. First up is the first phone with a liquid lens camera technology that mimics the human eye. They're using it on the telephoto camera. It's made out of a flexible film filled with transparent liquid. It can change its shape just like the lens in the human eye thanks to a precision motor. The lens offers 3x optical magnification and has an 8-megapixel sensor sitting behind it. The advantage of the liquid lens over traditional design is the ability to focus at just 3 cm for macro shots, as well as focus on distant objects for zoom shots. That said, the inner display has no cutout for the camera and it's 8 inches big. Xiaomi claims it's the biggest display on a foldable smartphone, although Huawei may disagree with this. Xiaomi has also enabled a desktop mode with multiple resizable windows to take advantage of this big display. The external display measures a 6.52 inches with a 27:9 aspect ratio, which is quite long. Interestingly, the outer display has a 90Hz refresh rate, while the inner one has only 60Hz. Also, the outer display has chunkier bezels. Xiaomi says the phone is available for around $1,500 in China, but unfortunately, they are not launching this phone in countries that are not called China. But in any case, the Mi Mix Fold along with the Mate X just so clearly proves that Samsung had the right folding idea all along. The Android market flourishes with experiments, but recognizing what works better resets the room and drives innovation in a more focused direction. Of course, with that being said, do let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.